You see? Now it's there forever, Maggie. You'll never have to get married. Can't take your clothes off. Not for anybody. You're better off. No man will want you. Never have the burden of kids. You're lucky. You thought it was good to be cute, to be sexy. A woman is better off loathsome in this world.
You're right, Ma. She ain't so much anymore.
I told you. See, a woman knows these things.
Nah, she ain't much at all.
You boys better string her up again. Wait a minute. We've got her so no man will ever want her. Problem is, see, Meg may still want him. Life a torment there. A woman doesn't want a man all over her body. No. She just wants him in one particular place. You girls know what I'm talking about? Well, darlings, you will. A woman wants a man between her legs, one little spot. You take out that spot, you know what happens? You take out all of her desire. You take it out forever. It works. They do it some places all the time, like it's just the usual thing to do when a girl reaches a certain age. Places like Africa, New Guinea. They even consider it a civilized practice, so I'm figuring, why not here? We just take out that one little spot. We'll burn it out. And then our Meg will be perfect.
Fuck!
Just where the hell do you think you were going? Off to tell that stuck-up bitch of a mother of yours? Or how about Officer Jennings? Well, I guess you're with her now. Not quite sure what we'll do with you yet, but we'll figure something out. Just be glad you haven't got a little spot like she's got. Then again, you got two friends of your own to worry about, don't you? Tie him up, boys. Now, where were we?
Thank you.
David. Do you hate me?
Of course not.
You should. And Meg should too. Because it's all my fault. Without me, Meg could have gone last night and not come back.
She tried, Susan. She tried and they caught her.
They caught her when she came upstairs to get me. She got out smiling.
I didn't. I let her out. She was supposed to come back for you later. Why didn't she just run?
I think because sometimes Ruth, she touches me. And once she made me bleed. And I told Meg, and Meg got real mad and told Ruth that she knew what she did. And then Ruth beat her again. Beat her bad. She should have gone without me. I didn't mean for her to get hurt.
Easy. It'll be okay. Meg. Meg, don't do that.
Yeah.
Yes, it's me. Susan's here too.
It hurts so bad.
Don't move.
Meg?
Meg. Sorry, Meg. I'm sorry.
It's okay, Sus. We try.
Is it night? Supper time, I think. When I don't come home, my parents will worry.
I can't anymore.
Just rest. I gotta find something to hurt them. To get us out of here.
There's nothing.
You don't know how many nights I tried.
There's this.
Maybe. But we need something else, though. Ruth, Mr. James. It was Ruth. She did this to Meg. Now she's in trouble.
You stay here with her.
Come on. It's okay.
Thank you.
okay. Sure. Can you get my mother's ring back for me? You've been that for me. A dream. I have a lot of dreams. I have them and then they go away. I don't understand. How she could burn me down there.
Please. No.
You're taking care of me now, aren't you?
Yes.
Susan, too. Yes. I think we're gonna make it. I think I love you.
The past catches up to you, whether you like it or not. It can be a gift or a curse if you let it. I will never forget the gift of Meg Laughlin, though I am plagued with the torment of failing again, failing somebody. But as she taught me, it's what you do last that counts.